Good night to everyone. Yeah, good night, Honorable Prime Minister and Honorable Glenn Phillip and Honorable Martin and the Attorney General, Jason Hamilton, and the lady who chaired the proceeding tonight, and to everyone. Now, my question to you, Mr. Prime Minister, how great you see the Constitution that had been modeled from 1962 and have engaged in the 1983 to 2014, how people could be socially represented when we go to court for our rights, as we see, as Rasta in particular, have faced challenges when it comes to herb. And we'd like to know how we see our protection have been facing in these court matters, because we say it's a thing that we deal with for a social gathering.
Allow him to have his say, please. Let's not go down that road.
Mr. It's about respect around here, and a lot of people got to understand about people respect and rights too. I mean, it means no kind of thing we're going to challenge him about who is who. It's about rights. And then come to say who is who. I don't think I feel that around here. Anyway, Mr. Prime Minister, I would like to know how you see it with the Constitution to protect our people, not just Rasta alone, but our people's rights, because the courts don't defend the people how we're supposed to be defending.
Thank you very much for that.
The brother is a brother who always asks about the rights of the members of the Rastafarian religious faith to use the herb for religious rites, R-I-T-E-S. And we continue to say that although we understand that the marijuana may be used to create the atmosphere, the feeling, the environment, to intone the spirit of God, it is illegal on the law books of St. Kitts and Nevis, as it is in several countries around the world. But we believe that the Rastafarians have rights. And if they are saying that they believe it is their right to use the herb as part of their worship, governments in the Caribbean have come to the point of saying, let us examine to what extent they may be able to use the herb as part of their religious rites. Let us examine to what extent the herb can be used for medicinal purposes. Let us determine to what extent must the use of the herb be limited for entertainment and social purposes. And so very recently, the heads of government within the Caribbean community, we've come together and we have set up a commission, not only a region commission, to study the use of the herb for medicinal purposes and other purposes. But we have also followed suit and we are pursuing it at the domestic level, where we would be inviting our citizens, those who feel strongly against the use of the drug, because we know that there have been serious damage to the minds of adults and youths in continuing use of the drug. We know that the drug has unmasked serious psychotic illnesses that otherwise may have laid latent in someone's lifetime, but which may be unearthed, unmasked by the abuse of the drug. And so we have to be careful here. And so we are asking those who have strong feelings against it to express those feelings. And those who have feelings in support of it to express those feelings. And so there will be a national commission, apart from the regional commission, to study the use of marijuana. We want to have a domestic and local commission to also study the use of marijuana and advise the government as to how best to treat what people are claiming is their right to the use of the drug. So the brother, to a large extent, always opens my mind. His questions are usually very profound, very stimulating, very challenging. Let us give the brother a round of applause.